In this lecture, we will discuss the chopper-controlled DC drives, and because in the last lecture we covered the three-phase drives, that is three-phase converters feeding DC motors. Now, before looking at the chopper drives, one small item need to be covered, that is the dual converter in the three phase drives. But these are quite common in industries, that a dual converter is nothing but two converters feeding the same motor. Okay. Now, the typically there are two converters here, EA, that is converter 1 and converter 2. Now, there is a which will be feeding the motor. Okay. And the voltage from 1 will be Emax cos alpha 1. We know they are proportional to the firing angle, cos of the firing angle, and this voltage would be Emax cos alpha 2, right, because they are feeding a motor. Now, that means it is a 4 quadrant drive, this is a 4 quadrant drive. It means if you have two converters, you can have both motoring and braking or regeneration on both sides, and both forward and reverse direction. Okay. Now, this since EA1 and EA2 are the voltages which are produced by the two, now ideally this EA1 should be equal to minus EA2, or EA1 plus EA2 should be 0. Ideally, there are two converters feeding the same motor. Okay, one will get EA1, other will be minus EA1. Okay. Or Emax cos alpha 1 is equal to minus Emax cos alpha 2. So, what should be the firing angle? No, it should be such that alpha 1 is the firing angle of the first converter, and the alpha 2 is the second converter. Okay. Or cos alpha 1 plus cos alpha 2 is 0, which means alpha 1 plus alpha 2 must be 180 degrees. So, that is one of the condition of a dual converter. Okay. So, if you plot, supposing this is EA1, okay, and then this will be EA2. Okay. Now, for this is alpha. Okay. Now, when EA1 is motoring, this will be inverting, that is this is EA2, because always EA1 plus EA2 should be 0, okay, for different alpha. Okay. And this is when at this angle, this will be EA1. So, EA1 goes negative beyond this point. And what is this point? Alpha is 90 degrees. Okay. So, this will be pi by 2. Let us say this is pi. Okay. Now, this is 0. So, you may have to find out this is a relation, just to know that the two angles must complement each other, so that alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is 180 degrees. Okay. Okay, this was only a small portion which was left in the last lecture, so I thought I could cover this. So, now let us go to the chopper. What is a chopper? It is basically a DC-DC converter. You have a DC supply, that means from fixed DC. Yes.
Why were we using it? Why were we using the dual converter if EA is 0?
Which one? No, I mean EA is 0 means the speed is 0. That is also one of the conditions. A motor speed, after all, when you are reversing, you want a variable speed both in the forward region and reverse region. But there is also a speed when this is neither motoring, neither forward nor backward. That is the zero speed. Right?
And that was condition.
That means you would be able to, I mean, yeah, the motor will be supplied such that there is a speed variation required in both forward and reverse direction, adjustable speed. So, what is a chopper? I hope you have studied enough on choppers on the power electronics course, right? And that means it is a DC to DC converter, that is, you have a fixed DC to variable DC. Okay. Now, in principle, there are two types. You can reduce the voltage or you can increase the voltage. When you reduce the voltage, it is called a step down chopper or a buck chopper. If you increase the voltage, it is called a boost chopper. Okay. And let us look at each one of them in basic operation. Okay. Now, this is called a buck chopper or a step down chopper. A step down chopper, this is the E is the voltage. Okay. And what is a chopper? Chopper is a switch which switches on and off, okay, using the switching devices which can be easily commutated, right? And this, now in this circuit, supposing this is the load, of course this is an inductor, okay, and there is a freewheeling. So that means either if CH on, when CH is on, that voltage will come across the load, right? When CH is on, what will happen to D freewheeling diode is off. Okay, that means there is a on period, T on. That means there is a period on, that is the voltage EA across the load will be equal to E. Okay. Then if the CH is off, what will happen? There will be a freewheeling diode, because there is energy in the inductor, it will try to discharge through this. Okay. So, there is a case of chopper off, but the freewheeling diode is on. Okay. In that case, what will be the voltage across the load?
Zero.
Will be 0. Okay. So, there are two states, T on and T off. Okay. So, we will say that there is a period T on in which chopper is on and D freewheeling is off or open. The chopper is closed. So, there is a period T off where chopper is open or off and freewheeling is closed or on. So, here the EA we have said is EA we have said is 0, voltage across the load is 0, okay, but current would continue. So, in both cases current may not be 0, here definitely not 0, here it will be not 0. Okay. And we define a duty cycle, we define a term called a duty cycle. what do you say, call it as epsilon. Duty says epsilon is defined as the T on over T on plus T off, right? Or what is T on plus T off? Is time period, you can say, is T. So, T is T on plus T off, right? And also you can define a frequency of switching. What will be frequency of switching? 1 by T. So, these are some of the standard definitions of terminologies used in choppers: on time, off time, then duty cycle and the frequency. Okay. Now, with these definitions, the curve will be like this. E A, it will be this picture. E A will be E during on, 0, and then again E like this. Okay. Ideally. And it might also have let us say some currents which will rise and come down. So, this may be the voltage E A, this may be the current, let us say I, okay, across the load. So, that will, when it is on, it will increase, then discharge will come down like this. So, this will be the, so you have you can have an average, some average voltage, let us say E naught, and you can also have some average current I naught. Okay. So, we have a definition, E naught is the average voltage and I naught average current. So, that is the average of this. So, you know that by epsilon control, you can control the, so what we do is by epsilon control, we can control what? We can control E naught, average voltage across the motor, right? And also in the, then it will also will have a bearing on the, can it control I naught? Decided by torque. So, and also the ripple is controlled. See how much, supposing you know you have a waveform like this, then you may have I like this. Okay. So, this is called the ripple or delta I. Delta I is a ripple, that is the variation from minimum, there is a minimum I minimum to I maximum. So, I max minus I minimum, you can call it as delta I or the ripple. Is it clear? That ripple is, now what epsilon does, suppose your average current is decided by the torque I naught. Now, let us take a second case where you have some other sort of chopping cycle, epsilon is different. So, then what will happen for the same I naught? So, you are likely to have much larger ripple. Okay. So, here delta I, so here is less, delta I is less, and here delta I is more. This is one thing we observe, that is the ripple, current ripple will change. Okay. So, we have seen this simple waveform of voltage and current. Okay. So, what will be the, now these are the things, we know T on is on time, T off is off time, and epsilon is duty cycle. What will be average E naught will be? E into T on over T on plus T off by simple geometry, isn't it? What is the average value? So that is equal to epsilon times E, isn't it? This is duty cycle into E. Or what will be the value of epsilon, which varies from 0 to 1, isn't it? When it is 0, epsilon? T on is 0. And when it is 1, when T off is 0. Therefore, you can plot the average value E naught versus epsilon. How will that look like? It is a straight line, okay, from 0 to 1. Okay. And when it is 1, what is the value will be? E. So that will be the value of the voltage across the motor when it is epsilon is 1. Okay. So this is called a step down chopper. Okay. Now let us look at the step up chopper. This is the circuit of a step up chopper. Okay. Here there is a voltage source and you connect an inductor and you have a chopper here, right? Please draw the circuit. There is a voltage source, inductor and a switch, chopper which is turned on and off, and there is a diode here. And this is the load, and this is the voltage across the load is E naught. Now there are two instances, okay. That is when that means T on of chopper. What will be your circuit? Your circuit will be like this. So this is open because this is short circuited. This is T on of chopper, this is E, and maybe this is I. This is L. So this is like a DC source across an inductor. So, what will be the energy in the inductor will be E into I into that period is T on, is not it? If this is the current and this is the voltage, energy stored in the inductor through during that period is E I into T on, because it is a constant, okay, I mean going on. Okay, now, if it is off, what will be the circuit? So T on is off. Then if it is T off of chopper, what will be the circuit? That is, you have an inductor, of course, and the load. Okay, this is the circuit. In that case, it was, that means this voltage, whatever was there, let us say EL, will then be the one which will drive it through. So the under T off, energy released by inductor under this condition, what is the energy released by the inductor? That will be W naught is whatever was the E naught minus E into, say this is E naught, this is E, into current into T off. Okay? Now, if you neglect losses, this whatever energy that it has acquired, the inductor, ideal inductor, will get released during the off period. Whatever energy it has taken in the on period will get released in the off period. Okay, so, if you equate this, E I into T or not, T on is equal to E naught minus E into I into T off. Okay. Now, you can say that this simplification E naught will be equal to E into T on plus T off over T off, which is E into T over T off. E T on plus T off is T, this is T off. T off is basically 1 minus epsilon. So, E naught, that is the voltage across the load, will be whatever is E over 1 minus epsilon, right. So, what do you get? Now, let us plot that average E naught versus epsilon. Because we said E naught will be E over 1 minus epsilon. So, that is 0 to 1. When epsilon is 0, it is E. And when epsilon is 1, it is high. So, you had to be, you can't go into 1. Okay, let us say epsilon is half. Two times. So, maybe that means you have to maybe go like this, okay? It is twice E, and you can double it by just adjusting the value of epsilon to be half, and of course, then it goes very high for this part, okay? So, this is the step up chopper. Right, is it clear? We can have a step in, step down or step up chopper. Okay. Now, next is, for such choppers, what are the devices that you can use? As you have to see, what is one of the important requirements of a chopper is it should be easy to commutate. You can switch it off easily, and thyristors are a big problem because commutation is the big problem in thyristors. Therefore, we require what is known as a self commutated devices, and nowadays they are available. Okay, and MOSFETs are one which are self commutated. You can use MOSFETs, and you have power transistors. Okay, and you have IGBTs, that is insulated gate bipolar transistors. Okay? And the GTOs, gate turn off thyristor, because that is there, it is easy to turn off the thyristor in GTOs. And now another device which has come is IGCT, or insulated gate commutated thyristors. Okay, these are some of the devices which are suitable for choppers, unlike in rectifiers. Okay, rectifiers have a natural commutation process. Here it is, there is no natural commutation here. It has to be sort of forced commutation has to be there. So, any device which can switch off easily is preferable. Of course, nowadays the choppers are very widely used, electric vehicles, EMUs, suburban trains, and so on. Therefore, they have a widespread use. Wherever there is a battery operated systems are there. In industries, they are also, choppers are widely used in forklift trucks, that is for internal mobility of goods, they are called forklift trucks. It is called forklift because they have got forks like this, you can lift. So, it is called forklift trucks. Okay. So, you can, whenever you know, if you want to shift some materials from one place, maybe store to the shop floor. So, they just go to the stores, pick up and then bring it. So, they are all battery operated the vehicles which move inside the factory. Okay. Now, next we will look at having known what is the basic principle of chopper. Now, let us look at the types of choppers. What are the types of choppers which are in use for drives? Okay. One type is called a first quadrant chopper. That means you can have it in only one quadrant, means you cannot reverse the speed, you cannot reverse the torque. Right. So, current is in the same direction and the voltage is in the same direction. So, if this is driving a DC motor which has a current, let us say I naught, voltage E naught, so it will be positive, and this is the chopper which is a transistorized chopper, okay, and this is the DC voltage source and this is the freewheeling diode. Okay. Now, again the same thing, you know, when chopper is on, E naught will be equal to E. When chopper is off, then the voltage E naught will be 0 when chopper is off and D1 is on. Okay. Simple. Now, these are used only for low small units like less than 5 kilowatt, typical drives of this, but only in the case of traction drives there are higher capacities, maybe few hundred kilowatts. Okay. So, these are being used. Now, this single quadrant, the typical curves we have seen, so that means when it is on is E and when it is off. So, when on means what? This is chopper on, CH on. Here what is on? Diode is on, right? D freewheeling on. Okay. And the average voltage is E naught, which is epsilon E or epsilon. What is epsilon is equal to T on into frequency, where frequency is 1 by T. T on by T, you know, F is frequency is 1 by T. And this delta I A, the ripple, you can say E over 4 into L A F. In fact, this is one of the standard statements. And that means E over 4 into L A by T. Means if higher the frequency, lower will be the ripples. Higher the inductance, lower will be the ripple. Okay. So, you have to try to reduce the ripples. Is it okay? So, this is about the single quadrant drive. So, with the average voltage and the ripple, which are two quality functions of a chopper. Okay. Now, there is another called a second quadrant or regenerative chopper. First is just a motoring, it does motoring only. Now, in this case, it is a regenerative chopper, means it cannot, the current is reverse. Okay. So, here while E is positive, regenerative means E is positive, but I is negative. Okay. Now, this voltage across this, that is E naught, sorry, here E naught is 0 when this chopper 2 is on. If this is on, means it is short circuited, no voltage across the motor. And when this is off, diode is on. Okay. That will be voltage across the motor is E, but current is reversed. Okay. And the speed would be epsilon V by K phi, because that is the voltage, epsilon is the duty cycle, minus R A K phi by K phi square into torque. So, it is a characteristic of the regenerative mode. Okay. Or in other words, is it okay? This is just another type of chopper. where you reverse the positions of diode and the transistor. Okay. That means this will be a first quadrant, this will be the second quadrant. This is the speed versus torque. So, here you have a first quadrant chopper, here you have a second quadrant chopper. Okay. So, here you are motoring and here you are regenerating. Okay. So, whenever the you operate here, it experiences a negative torque, right, a regenerative torque. Okay. So, that is, I mean, usually in separately excited machines they are all parallel curves which you are aware of. Then there is a third one called a two quadrant type A chopper. That means the first two we have seen is only one quadrant, either it works in the first quadrant or in the second quadrant. So, one is only motoring and there is only regenerative. Okay. This one is called a two quadrant or a type A chopper. So, here you use two choppers, two transistors. Let us say this is transistor 1 T1, this is transistor 2 T2, okay. And this is diode D1 here and this is diode D2 here. Okay. Now, that means it is effectively there is one switch here, one switch here. Now, let us look at how it operates, because this is the E0 is the voltage across the motor. This E0, that plus minus, is the voltage across the motor, which will be the same as E. When will it be same as E? When CH1 is on and CH2 is off. Okay. So, E0 is E when CH1 is on or D2 is on. So, if this is off, you see when CH1 is on, the current will flow this way. That means the motoring is, so current can go. This is the speed versus torque. So, current can go this way or current can go this way. So, that is why it is called a two quadrant. But it E0 can go, can never go negative. This E0 cannot go in the opposite direction. This is proportional to E0, this is proportional to I. Okay. Now, next case is what will be I0? I0 is positive when the CH1 is R, okay, and then is negative when the current flowing through this, either it comes through this CH1 or D1 is on. Okay. So, the current will flow in this direction, okay, in one way or in this direction. Okay. And this will be our results. Okay. Now, this is one way, is it clear that we have a possibility of current going in or current going out? Okay. Because current can go out through this chopper also, okay, and current can go out through this D2. Current goes out through CH2 or D2, current comes in through CH1 or D1. There are two possibilities. This can be off. When this is off, this is on. Okay. Okay. Now, that means in this one, forward motoring what will happen? CH1 is on, maybe we will see that. Let us understand. Forward motoring is that CH1 is on, okay, that is this position, and next is D1 is on, right? Either this goes like this during on period, when this is off, it will freewheel through this. Okay? So that is this situation. So you have this curve, so you have the original current and current ripple and IA. This is I naught and this is IA. This is called forward motoring. Okay? So the devices which will be operating will be CH1 and D1 in sequence. Okay? But definitely when D1 is on, CH2 must be off, isn't it? When this is on, this must be off. Okay. Similarly, when this is on, this must be off. Okay. Now, what is braking? Because you are only having a forward braking, either forward motoring or forward braking. Isn't it? What is the forward braking? Where it experiences negative torque. I0 will be negative because this is 0. I0 is negative. This is forward braking or regenerating. Now, that means this is D1 is on. Sorry, D2 is on. Forward braking means when D2 is on, when this is on, voltage across the motor will be the same. Okay. Then what will happen? Here what is on? You know, this is T on, isn't it? What is this period? T off, what is this period? What is on, what is off? So here, because it has to flow this way, so CH2 must be on because it is closest the circuit through CH2. So here CH2 is on. I think let me make it clear. So in this, CH2 is on, right? That means it is D2 CH2 which will be. So either when D1 CH1 here is D1 C and chopper 1, and here is D2 and chopper 2. Is it clear? This is how it will be operating, T on and T off. Okay. So either these two combination will work for braking, these two combination will work for motoring. Okay. It is just a combination of the earlier systems. Okay. There is another variant of the things is two quadrant. Here which were the quadrant it was working? First and second. Here we are having first and fourth. So here torque is not changed, speed is reversed. This is called a two quadrant type B. That's type A. So we have CH1, D1, CH2, D2. So it's possible that you can have these two. CH1, CH2 on means what? What is this? Which quadrant it is? Quadrant 1, isn't it? Okay. This is on, this is on, these two are open. Right? So, this is quadrant 1. But, and also that is E0 is positive. Current is in this direction. Now next is when you apply minus E means this point should come here, right? Minus E means this point should come here and this point should come here. So where what will happen? These are open, CH1, CH2 are off, are open, and D1, D2 are on. So this is in quadrant 4. So here E0 is negative. Is it clear? Okay. So we have seen how by these switching arrangements we can get into different modes. Okay. for a single quadrant or multi quadrant operations. Now let us look at lastly a 4 quadrant chopper. That means it will be a combination of those. We have seen single quadrant chopper, single quadrant motoring, single quadrant regenerating or braking, then 2 quadrant operation, motoring and braking, okay, another 2 quadrant. So it is 1 and 2 or 1 and 4, but we want to have 1, 2, 3, 4, all 4 means I need to have forward motoring, I need to have reverse motoring, I need to have forward braking, I need to have reverse braking. Okay. All the 4 are necessary for a typically in a hoist drive and things like that. So, we want to have a 4 quadrant drive. This is the circuit for a core. Please draw the circuit. So, these are CH1 D1, CH2 D2, CH3 D3, CH4 D4. Okay. 4 are there, and this is. So, when forward motoring, which do you want in this circuit? Okay. Let us say forward motoring. I want forward motoring. Chopper 1 and chopper 4 to be on. Right, and chapter 2 and chopper 3 to be off, right. So, this must be your route, okay. But how do you chop it? I mean, that means there should also be these two. When it is off, what will happen? Yeah, there must be a freewheeling possibilities. So, the thing is CH4 on, CH3 off, because one of these off, and CH1, CH2 operated. So, E0 is positive. So, that means this goes here, but this current is also reversible. Okay. Now, if CH2 is on, CH1 is off, and you can also operate CH3, CH4. Okay. So, one way is you allow for the respective chopping to be done as a combination of all the earlier sequences. Okay. So, this is how you can get a 4 quadrant operation. Because you do not want all the time on, there is no, because you want to have controllability. So, controllability is it must be off also. When it is off, there must be a, if these are off, there must be a freewheeling possibilities. Where will be the through, the derivatives you must have a, which route you should follow. Supposing these two are off. Okay. So, it should go through these routes, okay, correspondingly. Okay. Because E should be 0, because this can come here, okay. This across the voltage, it should be a freewheeling possibility must be there, okay.
But there are two ways of operating it, bipolar and unipolar.
Yeah.
So, if we operate chopper 1 and chopper 4 in a pair, it will be a bipolar switching. We will have E and minus.
Yeah, yeah.
So, that case we won't have freewheeling. They will be conducting through
the. No, you can freewheel through choppers also. Okay. I mean, you must try to say which devices has to be operated for the respective this thing. Okay. So, either, you know, as a chopper of, you know, CH4 on and CH3 off, that is, this is on and this is off. Okay. Then CH1, CH2 are operated. Okay. That means you can alternate this, right? And you can have E0 can be positive, and I0 can be reversible. The other case, E0 can be negative and I0 can be reversible, right. So, either you apply a voltage. So, this point comes here, supposing this point comes here and minus. So that means when this point has to come here, how will it come here? It can come through this or through this. Okay. And how will this point come here? It will come through this closed or this closed. Okay. So you have to do, that means you nowadays, you know, all these things are done through microprocessors and DSPs and so on. So the programming is done such a way that you can get the proper switching of these things. Okay. Now that means you can have a forward motoring or reverse motoring. I mean same, CH1 on and CH4 on, okay, and here D2 and D4 on. So you have this CH1 on and CH4 on is on. Okay, let's look at. I think to understand, see, you want forward motoring. Forward motoring is you have E. Okay, then you have CH1 on and CH4 on. Okay, this is on and this is on, so you have plus E. Okay, then if you have D2 and D4 on,
so it's D3.
Huh?
It's D3.
Which one?
D2 and
D3. D2 and D3, is it? Okay, so it is D2 and D3 on. What will happen? That will be off. This should be off. Okay, so this should freewheel. Okay, so that's how you have a. But E can also reverse, right? So you can have this type of one. Then of course you can have reverse braking. Reverse braking means, you know, you have when E is negative, I is positive. So that is the reverse brake. Reverse braking means E is negative, I is positive. Okay. So you can try to understand this. Is it okay? How we can have different ways of control of a DC motor? Okay. Next, let us look at how to analyze. You have done it for this thing, it does not take much time to understand. How do you analyze a chopper fed DC motor drives? Okay. Then let us say this is the circuit. You have when it is on period, you have a standard equation. E will be equal to RIA plus LIA DIA by DT plus KFIA N into K residue into N. Okay. Then R0, other time is 0 is equal to RIA plus this one. So when it is off, the voltage is 0, same equations between T on to T and 0 to T on. Okay. So these equations you are aware, and there will be a solution to this. So from 0 to T on, that equation you have a standard differential equation solution. IA is E minus KRS by this into 1 minus e to the minus T by tau plus I minimum e to the power minus. This is based on the initial condition, because you are starting with a minimum current. I minimum was the current at the time when that has started. So you have this combination. Okay. And what will be IA? For this is for the period 0 to T on, then you have IA is equal to minus K. This is for the other period. Other period, the time T dash we have taken. And T dash you have taken as the time from the time it starts. So T dash, what is the T dash and T relation? See, I have taken T dash instead of, it is T for the T on period. Okay. Yeah. So that is T dash is equal to whatever T minus T on for the second cycle, because you are going to have some response in T on period, and then it will come to some other response in the T off period. So any time T, I mean I have just taken from here, it is a T dash. Okay. And of course, it's just a manipulation of the equations. You can try. So I max, what will be I max when t is equal to t on? That is the maximum current. So you have started with minimum current. So I have one equation for the maximum current. Okay. When what will be the at time t equal to 0? What is the value? Is same as at time t equal to t. The current at 0 time is same as the current at the end of the period. That is one condition. Okay. Or that means you can find out I max and I minimum. These are some analytical expressions in terms of the parameters. I minimum is minus k residue n and so on. Okay. So you have two equations for IA, and that means the I minimum is E over Ra plus KFn into e to the power of t on by tau minus 1 over e to the power of t by tau minus 1. T on is on time and t is the period, minus k residue n over Ra plus KFn. That is the minimum current by solving that, because if it is already reached a steady state, you know at whatever was the minimum current is the time t equal to 0 is equal to time t equal to t, capital T, and t I maximum is when the same current which rises to at time t equal to t on. Okay. Now, this manipulation will give you what is the value of I max, I minimum and I maximum. I max is E over Ra plus KFn 1 minus e to the power minus t on by tau or 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau minus k residue n over Ra plus KFn. Okay. Now, if the current is discontinuous, after all, what will happen? After all, it can go to I max, then it may not reach I minimum, right? So I minimum will be 0. If current is discontinuous, I minimum is 0, but that will be much before the next starting, isn't it? Because see, the possibility is either you can have this type of an arrangement, right, or you can have after this it has reached 0. That means it will have a this type of an arrangement. Okay. Is it okay? So you have a period when it has gone up, and so this is when I minimum is 0. So that possibility is there. Okay. And discontinuous I minimum is 0 at t equal to tm. When is it 0? It at time t is equal to some tm. Right? So you substitute I to be 0 and find tm. Right? And you can find that tm. The tm is tau log e to the power of t on by tau into 1 plus e minus k residue by n or k residue n into 1 minus e to the power of minus t on by tau. So this is the value of the instant of time when current has comes to 0 in discontinuous mode. Okay. Now you have you are interested in average current. You know what is the value of current. So average current is 1 by t 0 to t iat in t on, and also t on to t m into iat. Okay. What will be RMS current? Same thing, standard equations. RMS current is Ia square t, and Ia square t, it is from 0 to t on and t on to t m and to the power of half, because the torque in a motor is proportional to RMS current square. Okay. And voltage of course will be equal to epsilon e. Okay. So So these are the equations you may have to derive, understand, and so you can find out the performance. That means if I will be, I minimum is at time t equal to 0 and t on it reaches I maximum, and then again it comes to I minimum, and we have defined this as the ripple delta I. Okay. Now this t dash is t minus t on, and this is a continuous current. Discontinuous current, it goes from 0 to maximum, and then dash of 0 time t m, and again continues, goes down like that. Okay. And this time constant tau is a LA by RA plus KAFN. That is the time constant that is understood here. Okay. So, these are closed form solutions. Of course, nowadays you can think of a numerical solution of a chopper. I mean, you have to simulate the chopper controller and include the motor equations, and you can try to get the performance. Okay. And there are some standard performance figures given of, let us see if it is, you can see it, typically of a chopper for DC motor, for different values, he calls it alpha in this figure. Alpha is a duty cycle. So, if duty cycle is 1, this is the normal characteristics, and if duty cycle is reduced, it will be the it goes like this, right. And these have been derived for different type of motors at different chopper frequencies and different inductance. This is another curve, affects the chopper frequency at different chopper frequency, how it could be done. Okay. That means, in fact, if let us see if basically you are interested in DC series motors, and the characteristics will be the series of characteristics that you will have. So, this is the normal characteristic epsilon is equal to 1, this is epsilon may be 0.5, maybe epsilon may be 0.2 or something like that. Okay. So, this will be the basic equation. Okay. So, we will stop here.